some blood for him, what's the last thing he needs? And they don't want to be, yeah, but they don't know if I'm demons. I feel like dying every season. I've been swimming in the deep end. My bitches know I'm leaving. Some morning, whether it's a reason or not. Nah, I'm gonna try to give any reason to stop.
P10 Nails to join. Oh wait, hold on. I think she did. Did I do it? Hold on. Did I do it?
Yep, it worked.
Okay.
There it is.
I don't know. I don't go live, so I'm new to this. Hi, how are you?
Hi.
Is the music too loud? I can turn it down, y'all.
Nope, I can hear you fine. I don't know about everybody else, but I can hear you fine.
Man, I say, look, I'm dropping shit. Hi. Is the music too loud? What we doing first, the eyeball?
Let's do the eyeball first.
Okay. Hold on, I'm trying to make sure they can see.
Something is echoing, though. I don't know if that's me or you.
It's me.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Is that better?
Yeah, I don't hear it anymore.
Okay.
Okay. We're doing two today. We're going to do the eyeball first, and then we'll do the bony bones.
Okay. Works for me. All right. So, y'all, bear with me, because I'm new to the whole artsy part of everything. You do yours with acrylic?
This is going to be gel polish, and then a little bit of hard gel is involved also, just a little bit. But you can also do it with top coat.
Left my, I had some paste, like some lace paste, and I don't know what I did with it.
You could probably make it work with that, too. You could get away with, like, a white acrylic, too, if you can work it well. I don't work well with managing that acrylic when I'm doing art, so it just doesn't work for me. But there's a few ways to get around it.
Gotcha. Okay, so yeah, I do the acrylic way.
Okay.
Let me just. Hey, everybody. Thank you for tuning into our live. gonna do acrylic and she's gonna do gel polish. So y'all gonna get two different ways on how to do a spooky eyeball.
All right, I'm gonna start with a black base. I'm gonna go in with the black polish.
Okay.
And they're both going to be on a black base, so I'll just do the second one while we're waiting on that to cure.
Okay. My bones one is on a black base.
Yeah.
I kept seeing this little 3D eyeball, so.
Yeah, they're very popular right now. There's 100 ways to do it.
I know. So I'm like, ooh, I'm going to try it. Y'all, if y'all hear like a bunch of noise, my neighbors decided to put a bouncy house in our yard today, I guess, for a kid's party. So they out there turning up. All right, so I'm just gonna get a little ball of this milky white acrylic. It's called Pina Colada. Can y'all see? Look, I'm over here trying to make sure everybody can see.
Yeah, it's hard to stay in the frame sometimes.
There, I can see right there. How long you been doing nails? You said since when?
It's been about 5 years, really.
Okay.
I'm still a little baby. Say that one more time.
What state are you in?
I'm in Georgia now. I started in New Jersey, so that's where I went to school. That's where I got my little license.
Yeah, we are in the same place.
But I'm happy I moved down here. It's been a really good move. It was the right choice. I didn't really make the choice, but hey, sometimes God makes the choice and that's okay.
Right.
And here we are now, but I'm really happy here. It's a good place to be in.
Can y'all see everything?
All right, so you have your eye down already. I'm going to put my eye in with white gel polish. You can also use, I'm going to use white art paint. You can also use white gel polish for this, but I like the art paint better because it stays in place. But there are a lot of pigmented gel polishes these days. They're not as watery as they used to be, so you can definitely get away with using a really good pigmented gel polish. When you're doing a circle.
Also, for those that don't know the difference, gel paint is a little thicker and more moldable than regular gel polish. So kind of know the difference. All right. That's my attempt.
Perfect. If you feel like you can't make a perfect circle, like you can't just eyeball it, and then make a plus sign first, right? And then draw your circle around that. So kind of find your midpoint and put a dot there. Then draw a line, whatever length you want. And whatever length that line is, make sure your line, the width is the same one so that you get an even plus sign. And then you're going to form your circle around that. So just start connecting your sides.
What color do I want the pupil to be?
Then fill in your circle.
Let's do some green, blue, blue. Oh, shit. Somebody type in spooky eyeball and bone so I can pin it so y'all can know what we're doing. Please. Appreciate you. Y'all know I'm not an artiste. I'm learning. I'm watching her and I'm learning.
We all have our strengths. Yeah, but I love the nail art. This, I actually learned nail art before I learned anything else. So it was really helpful.
Thank you. Hold on, let me hurry up and pin it.
And I'm just evening out the circle. You kind of work from the inside out. If you find there's uneven areas, just keep on bringing that brush around and around until you get a nice round circle. I mean, I'm not gonna lie, it does take practice. Remember to anchor your pinky. This is your anchor point. Your whole hand shouldn't be floating in the air. Okay, so we have that. I'm just gonna flash cure that. You don't have to with art paint. It's not going anywhere, but I just flash cure because I know I'm clumsy and I know I'm about to smudge it.
Okay, look, so that- I'm clumsy. Hey, sis.
So that is flash cured. Now we're going to do the drippy parts. We're not going to put the eyeball section in first. So same white so that our red shows up. You try to put red over black. If you try to put really any color over black, it's not going to be as vibrant. So you're going to put your white down first in the areas that you want the drip to be. And drips are super easy. Little brush technique. When you dip in your jar straight down and you pull it out, you see how there's that big old ball on the end? If we're doing line work, we don't want that ball on the end. However, with the drips, we do want that ball on the end to let the brush do the work for us. So dip straight into your pot or your whatever you took out of your polish bottle, straight in and then straight to the nail. You're going to turn your brush towards you, start your drip as low down as you want it to be.
Why am I
and then you're going to lift
you trying to do mine at the same time. Like, look, I'm learning at the same time.
So it automatically makes that drip shape. And I prefer this way than getting like a dotting tool. I find that the dotting tool makes like a really dramatic ball at the end of that drip. And it's just not a look that I prefer. So I want that smooth transition from the wide part of the drip to the thin part. And again, little brush technique. When you are going from large to small, so if I want a lot of paint down, I'm going to lay my brush down. If I want less paint down, I'm going to lift my brush up. So thin lines, only use the tip. Thicker lines, using the body of the brush. So when I'm making that drip shape, you're doing it all in one motion. So laying down into bringing up, and that's what's going to get you that teardrop shape. So you have one, and just no, do I'm a few falling. More.
Sorry.
Oh, was it falling?
Girl. Disrespect. Hold on, I'm trying to get back in frame. Ooh, that's cute. That's cute. So I used, for this little blue little people part, I used this. Get it at your local craft store. I don't know if, you know, Walmart sells acrylic paints, but I don't know if they have the glow-in-the-dark. I got this from Hobby Lobby. Yeah, but it glows in the dark, so that's why I'm using it.
I like that.
And then I got like some jelly red I'm going to use so that it's not too pigmented. And I'm going to put it around to kind of make it like pink eye a little bit. And dilute it with acetone as I go until I get the perfect shade.
All right, so we have our drips in white now. Now we're going to cure that again.
I cuss y'all, so y'all gonna hear that. I'm sorry in advance.
All right, that's done curing. Now we're gonna get some red. You can get red polish or red art paint. I'm gonna use the art paint again. And now we're just going to go over the drips in red. We're not going to go anywhere in the eye. So stop your red where the edge of the eyeball stops. Yeah, always remember to put down white first so you get it nice and vibrant. Yeah. You can do the red over the black if that's a look you're going for. That's fine.
It'll be like a more of a blood color. If you
mm-hmm. It'll be a deeper red. Mm-hmm. I would say this is more like a cartoon style, like illustration.
So y'all, my little brush is changeable. So y'all gonna see me changing out the little pieces. Nah, I hope these come out good, girl, so you'll be proud. I'm trying art. I'm stepping out my comfort zone.
All right, so that's what we have now. I'm going to cure that again. And I'm going to do green for the center of mine.
Oops, see, I was
green. Get a little green.
I got glow in the dark green, too.
I like that yours glow.
When I seen these little paint, it comes in. These are the colors that they come in.
Oh, yeah.
And I think it's a purple one, too, but they was out of stock of the purple, so. And they cheap, y'all. They was only 89 cents, so.
Oh, yeah, acrylic paint stretches, for sure.
Girl, I got paints for a year. I had since I was a kid, so. Yeah, especially if you just use the top.
Right, you don't even have to dip in. That's the other thing about nail art supplies. Difference between nails, the like acrylic and stuff, and nail art supplies. I feel like there's a lot of corners you can cut when it comes to nail art supplies. Sometimes you just want to get the right thing the first time and spend the money. But a lot of times, like even with brushes, you can find a way to just make it work. As long as the result comes out, make it work. Of course, with, you know, acrylic and stuff, it needs to be the right quality. But nail art stuff, you don't have to buy a $50 brush. Don't buy it.
Okay. I agree.
All right. So whatever eye color you select, make this section not all the way out to the edge, but pretty big, because then another black dot has to fit in the middle of that. So you don't want to make it so small that you then can't fit in another circle.
So, yeah, I'm curing mine real quick. Because that red is gel. Oh, that's about to be so cute. Oh, I wish I can go back to wearing super long nails.
Wait, why can't you wear long nails?
I worked in the hospital up until okay. So I haven't worn long nails in so long, so it's going to take me some time to get used to.
Okay.
Yeah. A lot of gaudy art.
Because you do very long nails.
Huh?
Because you do very long nails. You just can't wear them right now.
Yeah, so when it comes to like trying to pick up art and all that stuff, it'd be a hassle. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I hit my little blue part. I feel disrespected.
All right, so this is what we have so far. I'm just going to go in, put a little black dot in the center of that. Now the tinier dot, now that will probably be easier to do with a dotting tool. Just look at it and figure out whatever size works best for however large or small you made your eyeball. Most dotting tools come double-ended, and they have various sizes.
It's going to be a minute before I can do my little middle dot, because that paint got to dry.
Oh, because you used acrylic paint. Yeah.
Yeah. It was almost dry until I hit it when I put it in the gel lamp. That's why working with gel is so much better, y'all.
Yeah, it is more expensive, but it does definitely have the advantage of being finished when it's finished. Now, whatever color you chose for your eyeball, you're going to get just the smallest amount of black, like just a tiny bit. We just want to make it a little bit darker, not crazy darker, but just a little bit, and mix it in with that. We're going to add some details. See, I actually added a little more than I would want to. Well, I'm going to go with it. Let me add a little more green. It's darker than I want it to be. Now you're going to draw some lines in the colored section. So tiny lines moving towards the middle.
Where the little pupil is.
And this is just to add a little bit of detail, a little bit of dimension. I like dimension in my nail art. You don't want it to be flat.
See, I'm learning, y'all. I'm learning.
It's just those little things that add some interest.
Alright, y'all, gotta cure mine again. Hopefully, I
don't
plug it up again.
Do you usually work with acrylic paint, or do you like to work with gel paint as well?
It depends on what I need. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, like, I have like glow pigment, so when I mix the glow pigment with the gel polish, it be gritty.
Yeah, it is. It definitely is.
So I was like, let me just try this paint and see how it goes.
All right, now we're going to grab our red polish or art paint one more time, and we're going to add the veiny details. So we're not going to go straight in with red right out. We're going to mix it with a little bit of clear top coat. So put a little top coat on your tile or your foil or whatever it is you're using as a palette.
Or you can purchase like one of these little plastic palettes.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Local craft store, Michael's. Whatever y'all got.
And then get a tiny amount of red. We're going to mix. We want like a translucent red. We don't want it to be all the way opaque. So mix that up so it becomes like a jelly red like she was using before. And you're going to put this on the outer edge of your eyeball.
Y'all don't know, anytime you mix clear or top coat with a color, you make your own jelly colors if you can't afford to buy people's jelly collections, just so y'all can know.
Go around the outer edge. And don't cure it yet. We don't want it to look like a solid ring like that. So now that you have your jelly red down, then you're going to get some clear top coat and you're going to blend that edge right here. So between the edge of the red where you did and the white. So just start kind of patting that out and swirling that out. And this should be clear top coat on your brush. And this is a blending technique that I use a lot in anything that needs shading. I don't really do necessarily a lighter color. So if it needed to go, if let's say there was a shadow for whatever character I'm doing, I wouldn't mix like a lighter gray. I would add clear to whatever color is already on there so that it can fade out. I just find it's easier than trying to mix colors.
Or acetone, because acetone will mess around and rub off your whole design. And you got
right, right. Yeah. So acetone, when you're working with gel polish, I don't know so much about acrylic. I might do it to acrylic paint as well. But acetone will wipe off really sharp lines, and alcohol will do more blending. So if you're trying to like spread your gel, acetone is just going to take it all off. And that's with art inks as well. If you want to cut a shape into an art ink, like maybe you want to make a heart or you want to make a French tip, just with the art ink, acetone. If you want to spread the art ink and make it bloom, alcohol. All right, so that's what we have here. Now we are going to go in with, so thin brush, and now we want the full pigment of your red polish or your red art paint. And we're going to start making the veins. And with these, we want them to be really thin so that we really get that good texture. And so remember, when you're doing thin lines, use the tip of your brush like so. Don't lay it down. Lift it up.
I'm heavy-handed as hell. I hate that.
Yep, lift up that tip of that brush.
I'm so heavy-handed, and I hate it.
It's just practice. So we want just a little bit of paint on our brush, and we're using the tip, and we're going to start wiggling those lines to the middle. And as they get closer to the middle, let me see how close I can zoom in. You want that line to get thinner. So a little bit thicker at the edge of the eyeball than it is at the inside. And that's just going to create some movement, some more dimension. So that's one reason we did the like lighter red underneath, so that it has some layering. So it's just not like this stark white. So it looks like a tired eye. And you can make some branches off of the vein that you make. Do a little one to the side, maybe. You're just wiggling. These don't have to be precise, but make sure that they're all starting from the outside and pointing in. And they don't have to touch the actual color part. If they do, that's fine. I think it looks, I like mine with it not touching, but if you like it touching, that's fine.
I gotta cure mine again, y'all. Do y'all have any questions for us? Y'all can ask them below. Ooh, that looks so good. That's how my eyes was yesterday. Tired and red. Girl, going and going and going.
Busy, busy, huh? Okay, so we have that. I'm going to cure that.
Ooh, that is so cute.
Pull that back out. We're going to grab our white again, and we're going to just add a few more details. So we're going to add one dot at the top here and one dot at the bottom there. That's going to be like a little shiny part, a little reflection. So just a tiny little dot. You can use a dotting tool, or you can use, I would say use the tip of your brush. A dotting tool tends to be a little larger. So you're going to put it on the like right on the border between the black and your color right here. And then one more at the bottom on the other side. It's nothing big, just adds a little more interest. And then we're also going to add little white details in the drips. So with your drips, pick a side, left or right. Meaning left or right of the actual curved part at the bottom. and using that same technique that we talked about earlier with the pushing down and lifting up so that you get like a teardrop. We're going to do very tiny teardrops on the edges of these. So I'm going to pick the right side. And we're going to do like a little shine right in the corner here. That's it. Just the tiniest little brush stroke. Even though it's small, though, it adds, I keep using this word dimension, but I like dimension. Adds details. The devil is in the details.
That's the perfect word to use. Dimension.
And we're going to cure it. I know it seems like a lot of back and forth, but if you're doing like both your clients' hands, it's not as long. It's one of those things where once you get it, it doesn't take that long.
Damn it, messed it up. Ooh, how y'all draw all the time?
It looks good. No. All right, so ours is, if you're working with gel polish, ours is still flat. She started with acrylic, so she already had that 3D element. So she just started painting straight on the 3D, so she wouldn't have to do this next step. You can do this in shiny or matte. I'm going to go in with the shiny just because, the matte first, just because I like how it looks.
I like matte nails. A lot of people don't like matte nails.
You know, I find that some of my clients, it's hard for them to like maintain them. They don't really keep their hands out of the oil and stuff, and then they're disappointed when it's not as matte as the first day, even when I tell them, well, it's never gonna be as matte as the first day. But it's still, it's nice. I like it.
Damn, it's velvety. And that everyday wear and tear.
Yeah I do refuse to do matte white nails, though. I will say that. I won't even do them.
No, I wouldn't do it either. Okay, y'all, going back in the light real quick. I'm trying to think if I want to. I don't think I want to do an eyelid. Ow, no, I'm scared.
Those are fun, though. A couple weeks ago, I did that in my Halloween art class. Those are fun. Those are fun.
Because I did acrylic instead of the paste. If I had the paste, I feel a lot better. Because if I mess up with acrylic,
that's kind of it. Yeah, that's kind of it.
I'm new to this, not true to this, y'all. I'm trying to get true to it. Give me some time.
All right, and for us to make our gel eyeball 3D, we're going to get some builder gel or hard gel, depending on whatever your company calls it. I like the Poochie's Nails one. I know there's 100 different brands out there, but this one really works well for this kind of thing because when you wipe off the tacky layer, it stays really shiny. I've tried it with Young Nails. They have a really substantial tacky layer, so when I wipe it, it's like no matter how much I wipe it, it's still kind of cloudy, which really doesn't matter if you're building a nail with it, but if you're trying to do art with it and you want it to be really, really clear without doing another top coat, then yeah, doesn't help. So I'm just kind of floating this gel on the circular section and pressing it out. I'm not really painting it. I'm just pressing until it gets to the edges of that circle, getting as close as I can.
That's lit. That is so cute.
I love it. And then kind of swirl it off with that motion. And now you're going to turn your nail upside down. And what that's going to do is going to pull all the gel downwards. And then when you flip it back over, it's with a nice arch. And that's your 3D element. So keep looking at it. Make sure it's even in the middle. Keep turning it and moving it as it's upside down so that, you know, all the gel isn't falling to one side. All right, that's pretty good. I like how that's sticking up.
That looks really good.
Thank you, thank you. I'm going to put that into tour right away because the longer you let it sit, it's going to start moving back flat. So as soon as you get it into a position that you like, then move it right back. I mean, put it right in the light, not move it right back.
I'm sitting over here like, ooh, doodle it, doodle it.
You can try it. Try it with the acrylic. Be brave.
All right.
Like a nude acrylic, since your nail is already nude.
Oh, we did the most.
You know what? Yeah, let me. Okay, I'm about to go get some nude acrylic. Guess I'm going to use honey.
We did this one at the in the class. This one was fun. Well, it's like an eyebrow. I don't know what to call it. But yeah, this one was fun. All right. That, put that to the side. And yeah, that's pretty much that. Let me wipe the tacky layer off.
Oh, y'all, I'm about to attempt this eyelid. I'm terrified.
Have you done it before?
No, this is my first time doing this.
Well, I haven't done it with acrylic, but I have done it with the molding gel.
Yeah, and molding gel would be a lot easier. But hey,
I think it is. I do think it is. I guess with the acrylic. I guess you would blend the back first.
Yeah,
and then
hold on, Lily, don't get beside yourself now. I need you to slide on over around. Okay, you're trying to cure it.
Yeah, and then like, oh, because I know you gotta catch it. Like, yeah, like back, yeah. There it is. Oh, it looks nasty.
Y'all, this is my first time doing this, so I ain't doing bad for a beginner, first timer, though. Slide over here, show me one time, please. I think I'm gonna go back over it with the gel polish, that new gel polish, so we can.
Oh, okay. It. Blend that together. Mm-hmm.
Y'all, look at my eyeball. Y'all, I'm proud of myself for beginning. Now, the next time I do it,
as you should be.
It's gonna be lit the next time I do this little eyeball.
I like the lid on it. Gives it some life.
Yeah. And I was over here scared to try. And I only used a little dot.
So there's her acrylic, and here it is with the gel polish.
I'm going to add some more blood splatter to it. So y'all, it's multiple ways to do blood splatter. I did do a tutorial on it, and I believe she has a tutorial on her page as well. So y'all go check it out for those of you that want to try. Thank you. I tried, y'all. See, she real good at drawing and doing art and stuff. I'm a beginner.
All different styles. I can't work with acrylic. I don't trust myself with 3D art.
Me neither, girl.
I know who I am. Me neither. I know that self.
Okay, y'all, I'm about to polish this part up here so we can blend in with this, because right now it's like two-tone textured. So my little finger, oh, you done already?
Just with that, mine was much more simple than yours. You added a lid and you did all that stuff.
I know, over here being extra as hell.
No, that's good.
Because I'm trying to get more art. See, I be having so many ideas, but I don't be knowing how to execute it because I don't draw and do that stuff for real.
It's all practice. All practice. All
right, y'all. My little lid is curing right now, and then I'm going to do some blood, and then I'll be done. Top coat, and then I'll be done.
All right, while she's doing that, I'm going to move on to the... Or you want me to wait on you? I can wait. I don't want you to miss out.
I'm going to say, you'll probably be done way before me, girl. Okay. I think bones are a lot easier, though, because...
Yeah, no, they definitely are. Yeah, they definitely are much easier. Because you don't have to be as precise. You can kind of just make them any shape you want.
Oh, I'm trying to think. Should I do the straw method for the, no, that's going to be too messy.
Do you have a dropper? Like a empty dropper? That's not in anything? Like a fresh one?
Bag. I had to bring some stuff home from the shop.
Oh, okay. All of it is messy, really. Whether you use a toothbrush or the or the dropper or a straw, it's
you
all.
You know what? I'm gonna use this manicure brush. That's what I'm gonna use.
There you go. Easy peasy.
Easy peasy. So this is how it look. Can y'all see that? Hold on. I'm waiting on the phone to catch up. Now that I added this same color nude up here. Oh, should I add some lashes? No, nah, that's doing too much. That's how I be. You be like, should I? Ooh, this would be, this different. This cute.
I like it. I like it.
I try. All right, so I'm just going to put some random little splats, and then I'm going to take my manicure brush and add. Ooh, them kids out here having a ball, honey. Now, what the heck did I do with the brush? Okay, y'all, so I'm going to take, it's still got some on there, but I'm going to take this little old manicure brush, and I'm going to dip it in the red paint, and I'm just going to lightly dab it. So that's,
y'all can see how it looks. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Bruh,
now we'll be so proud of me right now.
All it takes is to try.
I know.
I think everybody can do nail art. I really do. That's a some level. I think if you're not doing some kind of nail art, I think you're really missing out. Number one, missing out on money. And number two, missing out on like creativity and opportunities to try something new, because it's doable. A lot of it does take practice, but honestly, a lot of it is not as hard as it looks. Everything has a technique.
I follow I've been following Hot Pink Zebra on YouTube for forever, since she first started her
YouTube. Yeah.
A kid, actually. That's how long she's been around. Her, Denise Johnson, Nails, all of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nail is that. Oh, my goodness.
That's how I got started in Poochie. That's how I got started watching growing up.
How long have you been doing nails now?
I started doing nails when I was 8. I got licensed at 17.
Nice.
And I turned 30 on the 2nd. So for a nice long time.
Yeah.
That I should know how to goddamn draw by now.
No. Listen, foundation will always be way more important than nail art.
Save it. Yeah, so we'll save this live and I'll upload it. I'll try to upload it to my page and YouTube. Whatever else I can better let me upload it, I will. So y'all, this is how mine came out. I'm about to cure it again, and then I got to top coat it, and then we're going to move on to bones. My black base is already down.
Okay.
So that's a good thing.
Now, are you going to do these in acrylic 3D as well, or are you going to use gel or acrylic paint?
This gel, let me see how the texture, I'm going to try to mix it with this glow-in-the-dark, the neutral.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. This white, so let me try to mix, see how the texture come out. Because I got these came from Hobby Lobby. They glow in the dark to kind of put stringly on the back, on the black background. Then at the end, I'm going to turn the lights out so y'all can see. Hopefully, it's daytime like hell. I'm a beginner too, only 2 months in. Definitely need to work on my foundation. Practice makes perfect, boo. Just keep practicing and it'll happen. I promise. I promise you. Just keep practicing. Don't get yourself down. Don't compare yourself to nobody else. This is your journey and your journey alone. You got this.
And take pictures. Make sure you take pictures of all your stuff.
Take pictures and also save. Like, you see how we're doing it on nail tips? You can do the same. This little stand right here that I'm using, it comes with 3 of these fingers, a bunch of little nail, the little brown parts, a bunch of these.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
$15, Amazon. Type it in, practice finger, and get to work. And keep all of them so that you can see your progress. I still have all the tips I had from when I was a kid. I still have them.
Right, right.
Got all 90s nail art on it, but I still have them. When I want to give up, I remind myself on how far I've come.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So, yeah, definitely just keep practicing. You got this. All right, let's see how this glow paint doing. This stuff watery. Hello, eyeball.
Proud of you.
All right, y'all. I'm trying to see if this paint gonna mix into this gel. This was a perfect consistency for mixing with this gel polish.
Oh, good.
All right. Y'all, this is my first time doing all of this, so I'm a beginner as well, so don't think I'm a pro. I'm going to try to add some more gel polish. That paint made it, like, super watery.
So are you mixing your acrylic paint with your gel polish?
Yeah.
I've never done that before. How does that work in the curing?
I'm about to find out.
Oh, you haven't tried it before.
I'm going to do a little sample, like, draw like a line and see how it comes out.
Mm-hmm. Never tried that before.
Me neither. This is my first time. I mix the pigment with it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, if you have, so some people do make glow polish. Some people do make different types of glow top coat. They come in a lot of different variations.
Mm-hmm.
But so I have different colored glow in the dark pigments. There's like pink, orange, yellow. This one I use the most because it's already colored, but I also have this glow acrylic. So if you want something to glow in the dark, but you don't want to mix it, because what she was saying about how it gets grainy when you mix it with gel polish, because it is powder. Mm-hmm.
Look at it.
Okay, yeah. I see. But what you can do if you have, so say you want your white to glow in the dark, paint your design in white and don't cure it. And then you can take either your glow pigment or your glow in the dark acrylic and sprinkle it over. You could mix it with gel depending on what you want to make. Because if you're wanting to paint really thin lines, that graininess is going to make it really hard to paint that line. So I find if you paint it in white first and then you sprinkle your glow pigment or your glow acrylic over it and then cure it, then you can still keep those crispy lines and then have the glow in the dark also.
Yes, ooh. Came out, sure.
Move it down just a little bit. You were out of the frame. There it is.
Okay. Girl, I'm looking at two phones. Well, I got the one phone I'm filming on, and then I'm looking at the phone and trying to make sure I stay in frame.
Because mm-hmm.
I'm notorious for getting out of frame, honey.
It's hard. Nobody tells you how hard it is.
Notorious for it.
Everybody just makes the videos that nobody tells you the behind the scenes.
Okay.
All right, so our bones. We're going to do more of like, they're not going to be so cartoony as the eye, but they're not exactly going to be realistic. So I say that because we're not going to do like two perfectly round tops and then a stick. One side is going to be larger than the other, but they're super easy. So you don't have to use a super thin brush. My brush is about, I would say, a millimeter wide. It's a heavier brush. It makes it easier for me to cover more surface area when I don't have to do so much detail. So I will say this is easier on a black face, so that when you mess up and when you're making the cracks, which you'll see what I mean later, you can't tell where the black paint is. But it's definitely doable on a color. It's just easier on the black. So got your brush. I'm going to start with the top of the bone. So make a, I call them nubs. Make a nub of whatever size. So this is going to be your bigger nub. So whatever size you make it, you're going to be the other, make the other one small. So it's going to look something like that, kind of like a flower petal, I would say. And then your other one is going to look, yeah, like so. So another nub, smaller. So you have this kind of weird shape right now. Kind of looks like a letter B, with the top B being smaller than the bottom bump.
Water.
You don't like the consistency? Mm-mm. It's a little too thin.
Yeah, it's extremely thin.
Yeah.
Which bone are you doing?
I'm going to do the, this is the top one first.
Okay.
So we're doing this one right now. So we have the left nub that's going to be big, and then the right one is going to be smaller.
Okay.
So right now we're just doing this top section. So start it, I would say, if you can wipe that off still, start it a little bit more to the right so that you have space for like this stick section.
Y'all, is my music too loud? Because it did just, certain songs did just get louder for no reason.
I can still hear you, okay?
Okay.
Okay. And now you're going to do a stick kind of straight down the middle.
Weird.
It's gonna come together. We're gonna make the stick part larger. Bring your nail a little bit closer to the screen. Let me see.
Can you see it?
Yeah, I would say make your bumps a little bit larger. It's going to be easier for you to do the details if they're bigger, so that you don't have to fit your thin brush in those like tiny curves. It'll make your life easier later on.
How's that?
Yeah, that'll be more helpful. Yep, yep, yep. So now we have this kind of shape. Now we're going to kind of blend the sides into the middle. So start making like a curve to start blending. You don't want it to be completely from the edge to the middle. You still want it to be like almost an S shape. So not completely straight down, but like a curved section. Like so. So it's not such a sharp turn. And then same thing with the other side. So it almost looks like a heart. Like a funky heart.
Like something coming outside of the heart.
Mm-hmm. Give me a little more curve, though. Give me a smoother transition between that right side and the stick section. Right now, it's kind of a square. Isn't that cool?
Girl, it's a hair. Oh, I hate when it has hair start sticking out at the end tip of the brush.
Yeah, yeah. It doesn't help you to get those smooth lines. Gotta chop it off.
You gotta
be careful when you chop it off.
Cut it off.
Gotta be careful because sometimes you mess yourself up more. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right, and now we're going to keep on going. So this is going to be the broken bone. So we're not going to go all the way down and do a second one. So you're going to continue with your stick, but you're going to make the left side come down further than the right side. So the edge can be jagged, but the left is going to come down into like a point, and that's what's going to be our break. And if it's not perfectly straight or where you want it to be, it's okay. That's what's cool about it being on black, because let's say I made it too wide. Instead of having to clean up so much, I can just go in with my black later and fix whatever shape I want it to be in. Because once I put that top coat on, you're not going to be able to tell where the black is.
Oh my goodness, them kids. Can y'all hear
them? Yeah. Okay. And now let's do the second one at the bottom. I'm going to turn this the other way. So this bone is going this way. I'm going to make the second one go this way. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So same idea. Except I want you to leave space for it to kind of come all the way down. So I'm going to put mine about right here. Make that left nub. You can kind of think about it like you're starting to make a heart. With two different sized sides. So if a B is kind of too hard to visualize, you see how that kind of looks like a heart? Mm-hmm. And then you can form it from there.
No, I don't like how they look. Sorry, y'all. That's how I be in real life. You can keep going.
Okay, no
problem. I'm watching.
So we have our little heart shape, and then we can flesh it out from there. So we're going to start with the top middle, and we're going to fill in that curve. So we don't want it to be so sharp. Just going to make a curve. So now you see how it has a dip instead of a point. And now we can do our stick straight down again. You can pick however long you want your bone to be. It can go all the way down. It can stop right here. However you want. So this one is going to be the full one. That first one was the broken one. And now from that middle line, I'm going to work my way outwards to figure out how wide I want the bone to be. About that wide. And I'm going to blend out my corners so they're not as sharp. So it has like a curve transition there. Do the other one too.
Okay, I see where I messed up at.
Where do you see?
Girl, mine wasn't even going the right way. I had mine going to the side. It wasn't coming out right. Y'all drawing?
Or was it tilted to the other?
Happy Sunday, everybody.
Oh, yeah.
It's the first day of the week in real life, real life. Bet some of y'all ain't know. When I found that out, I was like, wait. Well, why do you start everything on a Monday?
My week starts on a Tuesday. I take all Sundays and Mondays.
Me too.
Girl, yeah. Me too. All right, so we have the top there. Now I'm going to flip it upside down. And we're going to do the bottom the same way we did the top. If this were on a client, you can, like, once you really get it, you can just do it upside down. But for the sake of this, I'm going to do it the way we've been doing it. And if you feel like you can't do it upside down, have the client flip their hand and then work like that. You kind of have to visualize, since this is going to hang off the edge, I have to visualize where it is you want to put it.
Oh my goodness.
Partying.
The joys of being a kid again.
All right, so we have something like that. I'm going to cure that.
Huh. Okay. Let me keep going.
Mm-hmm. Keep going. Now we're going to grab our black art paint. Black gel art paint or black acrylic paint, whichever you feel like working with. All right, time for the details. Now, these are going to be real thin lines. So, little brush technique. When you load your brush up with paint, you're going to put it on your palette, your tile, your foil, whatever you're using, and you're going to pull that brush through the polish. You want to coat the bristles from top to bottom without it being heavy. So, my brush has a little curve at the end there. I like that curve, but you want to make sure you can still see it. You don't want all the paint to collect at the bottom. You want to be able to control how thick or thin your lines are going to be. All right, so I'm going to start with the top one. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, curve out those sides. And for the details, we're going to start with the top one. I'm sorry, that motorcycle was loud.
Yeah, I barely heard it compared to these boys over here. Here they blowing party horns.
And with this, we're going to start here at the top. I'm going to curve down in a U. This is going to be the dip in the top of the bone. So down and black, right? Up. We're going in with black. And when you make that U, you're not going all the way to the edge. You're just coming down. A little dip, like so.
Okay.
And then we're going to outline the rest of it. And this is where you can fix your mistakes with the white. So if you feel like it wasn't as smooth, if you want it to come in more, you can do that with your black. So like, okay, here's a good example. I feel like there's a bump in the white here and I want it to be straight. I can just come in with my black and make that straight. And you don't even see it anymore. There you go.
Y'all, this is my first live doing
nail art. That's exciting. Oh, I'm honored. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. To be a part of it.
No, I'm honored. This little guy here is creepy.
After you went and added that eyelid.
I did this one with some foil. I wanted to try to do a 3D skull on it. The vibe of the foil, that's what it gives me, like Guns and Roses with the skull head. Yeah, but I ain't that fluent yet, so you know.
I've seen a lot of people do 3D skulls with acrylic. It's very impressive. I can't do that.
I be looking like, I ain't that grown yet, so you know. Baby steps, baby steps. Oh.
Now here's how we're going to add the break details. So with this line, I just pulled it up into a real thin line. So what's going to make it look cracked is that the lines are thin. That's the important part. So did one there. And you can add more if you feel like you want it to crack more. And we're going to add one.
Ooh, I feel bad. Your bones break like this, boy. That's coming from somebody that broke their humerus into three pieces. That was the worst time of my life. My arm broke. When I first moved here in 2014, girl, I broke my arm.
Sounds terribly painful. I've only ever sprained my ankle. I only have one. This little baby right here.
You little know babe. The burning sensation from a tattoo? That's how it felt.
Oh, I can't imagine that in a whole arm. Oh my gosh,
girl. It didn't really hurt until when I got into the ambulance truck and they were driving a bumpy road.
Rude. Excuse me, I'm back here. We come down, do our hook.
Y'all, I'm over here holding my breath.
I hold my breath a lot too. My clients, no texting, no breathing. Don't ask any questions. Because if I mess up, I'm going to be very upset.
Okay.
Tiny lines. Don't do anything. That's the rules.
Okay.
And down here, I'm going to do that hook again. I'm actually going to go in with the black and take out some of this white because I don't like how it connects here. So I'm just going to do a little bit of editing.
Yes, with the editing.
That's why we do it on black, so that you can't tell. All right. Now for this one, we're going to add a hairline crack. It's going to be super tiny. You want it to come from the side.
Look,
and then just start wiggling. Just tiny lines. Start shaking your hand. That's one. And then you're going to make a Y shape. Just start branching off from the other one and wiggle again. That's two. I'm going to make this a little bit wider up here. And that's a crack in the bone. Easy peasy.
Ooh. Remind me of my arm.
I'm sorry.
Oh, girl, I look. It's perfectly functional now, so I'm good.
I'm going to flash cure that so I don't smudge it. Now we add the tiny little details. So you're going to get get most of the paint off your brush. You don't need a lot of paint. And we're going to go into the round edges and the sides. That's what we're focusing on. So you're going to pick whichever side you made bigger. Go into the corner of it and just kind of do one of these. Follow the corner. Just a little bit. It's just like a little sketchy sketch. It's barely anything at all, but that's what's going to start to add some, here we go again, dimension to your nails.
Word of the day, y'all.
Word of the day is dimension. We want to add interest to our nail art. We don't want it to be completely flat and boring. So there it is in one corner. Now we're going to come down the side and just like brush the line down the side. That's it. And then same thing with your other one. Find the bigger corner and follow the curve just a little bit. And I'm just doing some little sketchy lines. This one doesn't have to be perfect. I'll put one right here maybe. You don't want to overdo it or it's going to start looking smudgy, but just in a few sections, follow the straight and come and do another one in this curve here.
Oh, I'm sorry, y'all. Y'all can't even see. Why y'all ain't tell me you can see? Ooh, Lex, you next. Figure out something that we doing. That's what I want to do. Y'all want to start going live on Sundays. I don't be doing nothing. I'm trying to pick my cards and planning my week. Y'all go follow Nails by Lex. She's super dope, super creative.
Oh,
super creative. Yo, she did some aquarium nails with chicken noodle soup. Oh my god, that's when I fell in love with her.
I have to see that.
Girl, real chicken noodle soup in the nail. It was lit. Oh my god. Y'all, the painted color. She's super dope too. Y'all know I don't know how to draw. I'm over here learning. I'm trying. Practice make perfect, right?
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah, we
all I like it.
Have some blood dripping on the side.
There you go. See, now you can start adding your details. You can do something dripping from a little cracked one.
I'm smudged some shit and I got to start over.
That's me. I'm really good at spilling glitter and smudging the nail art that I just spent so much time on.
I really like how. Can somebody come get an eyeball on their nails? I'm going to add some lashes though. I feel like it's missing some lashes.
What are you going to use to add the lashes? Some hair, some like brush bristles.
The individual lashes? Just cut them real, real, real short.
You have to do it now.
I think I want to try this with the googly eyeball.
Oh, that would be a good idea. That's a good workaround.
That's what I was going to do. And I was like, that's the cheap way out. I don't want to do that. I actually want to learn how to do this for real. I'll be like taking the cheap way, the easy way out. Like, I want to, that's why I got into this, because I love the art. Mm-hmm. You can get so creative.
It does take time, but you feel so proud when you're done.
Listen, like, I'm proud of this eyeball, because I was like, oh, this ain't going to come out right. I'm a mess up.
And look at you.
They need to go see an optometrist, though, but, you know. You doing yours, Matt, or?
I'm going to do this one shiny. Oh, little side note. So if you're using a matte top coat, it depends on which one it is. Most of them I've experienced this with. Maybe it's just the makeup of a matte gel top coat. But when you're using matte, especially after you've done all that intricate nail art, if you remember when we all used to use like only regular polish and then you went over it too many times and it got like streaky.
Oh my god, that drives me insane.
Yes. So with matte, you have to be careful, because I find that if you don't get it in the first try, like it's gonna get streaky. It just is. Like, I don't know what that's all about. But if you pull and pull and pull, it's gonna get streaky. Let me see if I can.
Yeah, I'm trying to blast.
Show an example, because the first time it happened to me, I was heartbroken because I spent so much time on the nail art. Ooh, heartbroken. So if we... Let's say... We're doing like a...
This was nice. I like this. I'd be nervous to go live. I don't know why. I really honestly don't, y'all.
It helps to have somebody. I've never done like the duo live. It always feels weird to me doing it by myself because it feels like you're talking to an empty room.
And then I'm like, ain't nobody gonna watch my live. They ain't gonna watch it if you never go live.
That's true.
Yours looks so good.
Thank you. I love the hand painting. I do love it. I've tried thickers and I've tried, first of all, foil is the devil. I don't know how people do that. God bless you. But not once have I ever been able to get like when there's a foil design, like the foil is the design, like a pattern, I can't get it. I cannot get it in one shot. There's always pieces missing. I've tried every technique.
Okay, so I can send you some of my foil gel. I'm gonna do a foil thing. My foil gel is A1, I promise.
Okay, I believe you, because I have yet.
And I can send you some. Just DM me an address you want me to send it to.
Okay, sure. I'd love to try it, because they have a lot of cute designs, and I'm like, not for me.
I'm going to do missing one out. See how you get a
foil. I love that. Yeah.
That's what this is.
Yeah. That's what reminded me of it. Yep. That's what reminded me of it.
Y'all, this is my little bonbon.
I like it. Ooh.
Now, should I add some little split flats on the hold on, let me see.
And it would show up on like it would like show up on the white a little bit. Mm-hmm.
Overdoing it.
More is more. I don't believe in less is more.
There we go. That's good enough. That's as far as going. Then y'all can add like some little small stones in between if you want to, like how I did on this.
Ooh, get creative.
Yeah, get creative, y'all.
Get creative. Do your own thing.
That's the beauty of art.
Mm-hmm.
Such thing as ugly. Where is that stand from? Girl, Amazon, I'll text you the link. Here, I got the box right here.
Oh, are you okay?
Girl, my little light fell. Y'all see it got a little dark over here. I got, this came from Amazon too, y'all, this little light. It is A1. Wait, can y'all see?
Everything comes from Amazon.
Can y'all see?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah. So that little light. Look, I told you I'm looking on the other phone to try to make sure I can see. So yeah, this is the hand. If you can get it in brown or white. It comes with three fingers, the little space for this part, and then all of these. Amazon is what I be calling it. And so they,
I like that.
they lost that name though, because they've been tripping on my Prime shipping. I've been getting stuff a little late.
Yeah. What's the point of paying for it if you're not going to get it in time?
Oh, you know what I thought would be cute on the little what? Blood bubbles? Glitter. I don't know why.
Here you go. We all like shiny things.
But make sure before y'all do some glitter, y'all top coat the rest though, because that glitter, boy, that's the devil. That's a nail tech worst nightmare. Always, boo, anytime. That's a nail tech nightmare. You open up some glitter, you might as well move. You gotta move. Yeah. That glitter be everywhere. Disrespect.
Everywhere. And here comes Christmas.
Everything
red glitter all
red,
day,
green and silver, mm-hmm. Sparkle.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so y'all, real quick, if y'all do go and purchase this little finger, what I use to put my tips on it, I don't glue them on there, I just use these sticky tabs and I put it on there, and y'all see it stays perfectly fine. Mm-hmm. See, I took the whole thing off, it didn't even take it off of here, so. That's what I use, the press-on sticky tabs to put them on there.
Smart. Very smart.
You can also use the mounting tape as well. I know people have a lot of issues with trying to find a way to save with using them pieces, because you would run through them little brown thingies like quick, the little nail bed pieces like crazy.
Yeah, yeah. So and then you can't really use the tips anywhere. You can't like display them because the brown piece is on the back. Yep. So that's a really good idea. Mm-hmm.
I thought about adding.
So with a matte polish, so let's say we had this down and I'm getting my matte.
Mm-hmm.
If you, there we go. If you were matte, I would say get it down and do it one time. So it's fine right now. But if I was like, oh, I don't like that, and I keep going and I keep going, it's going to start getting streaky and streaky, and it's just going to ruin your design.
Do you use your mat often?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to say it might need to be shaken up. You know how when stuff
What? I've shaken and tried three different brands, and man... It's like every time. And the thing that convinced me that this is just what Matt does is that I saw another nail tech do it intentionally for like a design.
Look,
I was like, oh, wait a minute.
Matt. Can you see it? Hold on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I'm going to send you some stuff. And
I'm curious because it is frustrating. Yeah.
Okay, y'all, so I'm polishing this with my foil gel so y'all can see how you can get a full coverage.
Oh, yes, please.
And then I'm going to let y'all pick out which foil. Y'all, make sure y'all nail is fully coated. You know, looks can be deceiving sometimes. Like how you think your nail looks straight this way until you turn it this way and it's crooked as hell.
Mm-hmm.
We gotta make this a thing, going live doing nail art this week.
Oh, yeah.
So these are our two nails as we did.
Oh, I dropped mine. Yo.
Okay. So we gonna use one of these, y'all. Which one? Yeah, that definitely wasn't the way to open it. So this was the one that I used here. It gives me Guns N' Roses vibes.
I like it. There's so much going on.
Let's do the brown because you can see the brown more. Oh, damn it. It unrolled. Listen here. A little paper. Thank you. Stay there. Thank you. Great. I sell them, so I can send you some if you want some. Just let me know. All right. It's dried it, y'all. It's dried. You know, the grammar police. It's not dried it. It's dry.
My name's
dried. Okay. try to put a cover on my little striper brush, girl. Protect these little babies.
Mm-hmm. Gotta take care of your brushes. Absolutely. Take care of your brushes. Gotta take care of you. Now. Very much. Very much.
Okay, y'all. So, do I have some stuff? Or not. Or not. All right. You gotta do what you gotta do. All right. So, y'all, I'm just about to. Let me stand up so I can see it. Damn it. I still got a wrinkle. Foil is like, oh my God, the devil.
The frustration.
So y'all, that's how people know. Look, it's already stuck. So the foil is not right here. So y'all not gonna see nothing right there. It ain't. It wasn't that long.
Come over just a little bit.
Oh shit.
Mm-hmm. What kind of light do you cure it in? Because I'm wondering if that's affecting how effective mine is as well.
I got, girl, this old gel lip. It's the C&D.
Yeah.
This little thing I use at home.
Mm-hmm.
How do y'all clean y'all gel lights? Because acetone, it melts every damn thing.
You gotta be fast. You gotta use the acetone, but go fast. Don't sit in one spot.
It's like, okay, y'all, this is an electronic.
Definitely spray it on the paper towel and scrub.
On what, sweetheart? But yeah, so. My little Mickey chilling on his Louis V. Isn't that an actual bag? The Mickey Mouse Louis Vuitton?
And I think so.
It ain't much.
It was like a special release.
Yeah. So then you can see, like, right here, all of it came off.
Yeah, but all of it came off. Yeah, that is not. I need some practice. That is not how mine does.
Oh, yeah. My nails is just a natural nail overlay. I use Tammy Taylor P3. I've been doing nails for a very long time. And this is my go-to girl outside of my products and Young Nails and a couple other people I support their brands. But Tammy Taylor is the truth. She is expensive, but it's worth the investment.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Oh, thank you, girl. And my little nubbies. But yeah, so yeah, I'ma just send me your address, girl, and I'll send you some. Or we can link up.
Yeah, please. Yeah, since we found out we're in the same area.
I know.
Look at that small one.
I'm finding a bunch of people over here.
Got a network. That's a network.
It'd be hard. Well, for me, it's hard because of this whole COVID thing. I'd be like, all right, already putting my life at risk enough working. I don't be trying to get out too much.
I hear you. Absolutely. Do a little virtual meetup.
This is cute. This would be cute. Look
at that on here.
Look at this one, y'all. This foil, cute as hell. It's like
oh,
gaudy girly. I like
gaudy girly. That's a good name for it.
I like that. All I'm picturing is like gold with some charms, mm-hmm, and then pictures. You gotta have the '90s rings on. Like
that's what makes it. I don't know why it is that something as nice as the nails might be, something about putting rings on it just brings everything up.
You gotta accessorize. That's all of those accessories. It's the accessories that bring it home. Then it's a and this one is this Burberry Versace key mixture.
It was like gold chains in that one too.
It does.
Luxury.
Some chain art with some bling and some charms. Mm-hmm, there you go. Mm-hmm. We'll add some black French design. That's a set right there for y'all. And it's because you ain't even have to hand paint all this.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Y'all foils is lit. They on my website if y'all want them. Mickey, you can get some blood drops too since it's Halloween. Everybody bleeding.
Add it to everything. Instant Halloween.
Everybody bleeding, okay? I gotta figure out how to a better way to mix neon glow pigment, because I have my glow in the dark collection. I have the pigments for those, and I have red, orange, yellow, green, aqua, blue, purple, pink, and white. And I be wanting to mix them with like gel polish and stuff to do designs, but they do just like this.
So what kind of designs are you trying to do?
Like when we the hand painting stuff that we just did.
So let me pull it out.
I like that little stand. What's that? Let me see. Come back.
What'd you say now?
What stand is that those are on?
Oh, this is something that I not make, but that I sell. This is, let me go get the insert box. I gotta get a second box because I need to mount it on the
wall. I need to come get one of those for me or buy one.
So here's a blank one. They come empty like this, and I just put double-sided tape in there, like the clear mounting tape. You can use another one, but I like the clear mounting tape.
Girl, I love
it's tape, really easy to
move with it.
No, it's perfect. And yeah, it stays protected in the outer box, and you can change them out real easy because it just comes out like so. Oh yeah, I love them. I call it my art gallery. I have like 4 or 5 boxes up on the wall. Mm-hmm. And I can switch them out because they just pop out like so. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I gotta come get one.
And put it back in. Mm-hmm.
Ooh, y'all wanna see if this eyeball is gonna glow now. Hold on. Let me turn off all the lights.
Oh, that's what I wanted to ask you. But yeah, you send me your address and I can send you a few of these since we send a gift.
Yes, we can. It's too bright. Okay, let me try. My dog is going to be like, bruh, you've been talking to everybody else but me for hours. All right, it's a little darker. He probably ain't going to get much.
Switch this one
out. Oh, y'all, it do glow. But you gotta put it to your eye method. Hold on, I'm gonna take the phone into the bathroom, I guess. I don't know.
Get that straighter.
Can y'all see that?
Mm-mm, it doesn't seem to want to show up.
The disrespect.
We believe you.
Hold on. Let me get it. Okay, I'm looking up here now. So, see if I can get in frame better.
Oh.
There you go. There you go.
I see you. I see you. So yeah, it did glow. It do glow.
Oh, that's what I wanted to ask you. Do your pigments look like, do they look like this? They come in like a container like this. They're real fine and powdery.
Hold on, I'm trying to see yours. Where okay, so I do sell the neon pigments. I do have those, but I have for mm-hmm. my acrylics, I have neutral colored pigments mm-hmm. so that the acrylic base is a milky white. So if you guys want to mix it into something else, you can.
Mm, okay, okay, so, yeah. I see.
But I also have
the reason I ask is because of the texture. So if you're hand painting, so let's say you have the bones and you wanted the bones to glow. But I don't know. I don't know what color the pigments come in. Let's say you wanted them to be blue for whatever reason.
Mm-hmm.
Since the white isn't gonna, like, it's not gonna mix well, you're not gonna get like good painting texture if you mix in the pigment. So put down so black first, top coat. I would recommend top coat because sometimes when you wipe a tacky layer.
Okay.
What'd you say?
I said the way that those two eye nails is like they're looking at you. Okay.
Yes, they do.
What's the fourth nail? Is that lips? What is it? Zoom, bring that.
This one here?
At the top. The fourth one at the top.
This one here, the tan one?
Yeah.
Oh, that one was fun. It came out better than I than I expected, actually. So this is the one we did in my Halloween class 2 weeks ago.
Oh,
and we were using the molding gel. Mm-hmm. So we were doing the teeth, and then he has some nasty lips. Let me pull him out.
Oh, that is.
We did him all 3D.
I'm trying to get on that level, y'all. I'm trying to get on that level.
Oh, this was fun. I'm sure you could do it with acrylic, but I found it was much, much easier with the molding gel. Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. Poly gel too. Yep.
I have to do something with poly gel. It's the black eyeball. So y'all, I'm working.
Oh, it's nasty, isn't it? Oh.
Yes. Me and my vendors, we're working on launching a black acrylic glow-in-the-dark line.
I didn't know that was possible.
It's difficult, but I think we got it now because it's hard for anything to penetrate black pigment. But
right.
The samples that was sent to me was so lit, so...
Oh, now that's the first time I've ever heard of that. Ever, right. Ever, ever, ever.
Right.
Ever, oh, ever, ever.
I can't wait to drop that.
Oh.
But y'all, the fall collection is dropping on the 15th. I can't wait. Oh, that's cute too. See, it's so artistic.
Oh, we had fun. I love the hand painting. I love that all nail art comes in different ways. Like, I really, one thing I do not like is it's like when I don't like any shade nail tech shade, but when I see one nail artist like just dogging another one because of like their style of art. So they'll be like, I could never do bling. Bling is boring. Or they'll be like, I could never use stickers. Stickers are lazy. I just don't believe that. I do love hand painting, but
I prefer to try to learn everything else so I can be versatile. You never know.
Yeah. Someone
will come up and want some shit. So
absolutely.
I prefer
that. Absolutely. It's definitely important, but we got to respect all of it. We're not all good at everything.
Y'all see that dude that sold a piece mm-hmm. of tape, an invisible sculpture. Girl, I'm still tripped out about that. An invisible sculpture, I think it was for $18 million. It was just a piece of tape on the ground.
somebody.
Who just, you got money to waste, bro? Can you give it to me? Please.
There was another one where it was a canvas, and they like commissioned the person, and then the artist sent back a blank canvas and said, "This is the art," and they paid them already, and that was it.
Wow, no, the dude actually, he did an art exhibit, and it was just a piece of tape there, and he had this nice little story explaining his invisible statue, and somebody paid $18 million for that. Like, you pay $18 million for some duct tape. I could have gave you a whole roll.
But you got to tell the story. You got to be able to tell the story. It's when you don't do your project, and you got to get up in the front of the class, and you got to pretend like you did. Right.
Bruh, that's what I said. When people be like, "Oh, I ain't got no money," the man, it's hustles and everything. It's, man, he can sell a piece of duct tape to somebody for $18 million. Man, that blew me. I'm like, oh, I'm in the wrong business.
For real. I think that all the time.
Put a bottle down here and tell them this was the first messenger bottle from 300 BC.
Somebody will believe you.
Okay. Jesus held this himself. In this picture, you can see he was drinking out of this exact bottle.
People will buy anything.
Do that one now at the end, next to that green one, do that one glow in the dark? Or is that just the neon?
Oh, this one does glow in the dark. Let me see if I can turn off my light.
See, that's what I be loving, that glow, like stuff like that, and then it shines through at night. That is so cute.
There it is.
Y'all, thank you so much for tuning in into our Sunday Nail Art Live. We will be doing
it.
So stay tuned. We're probably going to put up some posts. Y'all get some suggestions on stuff y'all want to see. Ah, that's so cute!
That's definitely one of my favorite ones. And that was with the
Halloween press on set right there.
Oh, we had fun. With the nail art.
The V shape.
Oh yeah.
French tip back. That's creative.
And when you put this in a whole set, it is it's the cutest thing. Like, some stuff is fun on its own, but sometimes, like, when all 10 are together, it's just like such an impact.
That's a whole set right there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Love Halloween nail art.
I need to learn how to do hands. I be wanting to do some stuff, but it seems like it's hands easy. Hard. But I know it ain't nothing easy.
Practice. Thank you. It is my favorite. Yep, we have fun. I'll definitely be. I'll post the recording of the class on my website also. If anyone wants, it'll probably be up by this evening.
So yes, mm-hmm. y'all, you guys, she offered nail art classes. So if you're interested mm-hmm. in learning mm-hmm. how to get more creative for your clients, definitely go take it. Virtual, right?
Yep, all virtual. So, and they stay up for a month every time. So you can get access for as long as you need to. So this one will be up until Halloween, really.
Okay.
So whenever you're ready. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, we have a lot of fun. Yeah, I think everybody can add nail art to their repertoire. Just a little bit. The next one, I think I'm going to do it for Christmas. So it's probably going to be like the endish of November. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Somewhere around there, yeah. So do a little plaid, a little shiny things, maybe a little teddy bear, some hot chocolate. I don't know. I haven't specified the details yet.
I'll probably sit here and have a heart attack trying to do a teddy bear. Oh, you know what, though? Drawing might be a lot easier. In my mind, I instantly went to 3D. jab it with the dotting tool to kind of make the
but
firm.
People really do it. They do it, and it's amazing. It is really impressive.
Shout out to everybody, really impressive.
And they get it perfect the first time. Okay.
Love it.
Yeah. That's why you gotta know yourself. I know that that's not my loan yet.
You want to go live again next Sunday?
Let me see. Let me see what next Sunday is, the 17th. I think I should be open then. I'll double check my schedule and see what time. See if 3 p.m. works again.
Okay.
That's that's cool. That's cool. That's cool.
Collab and do some nail art, y'all. Hit me up.
Yeah.
I know my DMs are restricted. That's the right word. Restricted. So
okay.
I have a phone number so y'all can text me and be like, hey, I'm interested, or a comment or something. All of those sugar baby, sugar daddy, hair factory, lash factories that you got on my nerves. So when they made that feature that I can limit my messages, I took it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a lot of spam sometimes.
And then they'll follow you just so that they can send you a message. I'm like, bro, leave me be, please. Not interested. I don't know how I'm gonna get this red out of this brush.
That's just your bloody brush now.
Yep.
You gotta buy a new one.
It had most of it out, I guess.
Oh yeah, it did. Yeah, it did.
Do you guys have any questions before we get off, or y'all set? Everybody set?
I think we're good.
Thank you so much for going live with me. I really
appreciate it. Yeah, thank you for having me.
And I'm gonna do another bone nail. I got, you know, practice make perfect. I gotta do it.
Yeah.
Gotta do it. And I'm gonna send it to my homework, and I'm gonna send it to you.
Yes, I wanna see. I love seeing the work. I love seeing it.
To you. And don't forget to send me your address to send your stuff to.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Will do. Will do, my dear.
All right. Your Sunday.
Yes. Happy Sunday. Get some good rest.
Everybody. Thank you so much. Bye. For listening
in. Bye.
Don't save the live. Hopefully they let me. I will save it, though.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, we've been on live for almost 3. Wait, we've been on live for an hour. I forgot we started at 3. I'm like, wait, we started at
3. This was fun. I will see you next week, girl.
All right, see you, love.
All right, bye.
Bye, everybody.